Professional basketball, he ain't had from the camera and the media and all that. You know, cause most people with that much hype behind they fight, they get out, they run. They get out of there. Yeah, I seen he was
good evening, I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Kenny Atlas, and we welcome you to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, with a much-anticipated World Championship on the line tonight. Scheduled for 12 rounds of heavyweight action. We are looking forward to this fight, especially after seeing what happened at the weigh-in yesterday. A stare down that nearly resulted in a bout breaking out right there. Now they get to do it for real. Garrett's ring walk. He just exudes confidence, carrying himself like a champion. Opening 3 minutes of this scheduled 12 rounder. By Big Train.
Very similar to what you see Floyd Mayweather do. You know, make a miss, pull that shoulder back, and then come right back with the counter.
Targeting that jab with the right hand behind it. Scoring with that left hand. Hits him in the mug with the right. Another huge shot comes in early on in this fight from him.
Well, he understood that his opponent, Joe, was a slow starter. He's jumping right on and taking advantage.
Comes right back at him with a left hand. Right to the head with that right. Right hand over the top, very accurate with it. By Big Train. A stinging right hand. There it is! Oh, he's gonna beat the
He just threw a punch and had one coming right back at him. His opponent scored well with the counter.
Real good. Now you can do it. I know you can do it. You need a jab. I want to see your double jab, then the right.
Dollar Bill's got to be so careful here, Teddy. He was knocked down in the last round. And you know his opponent's going to be coming for him here at the start of this round.
But this is where you walk a tightrope, so to speak, because if he's too careful, as you alluded to, guess what? His opponent walks in, the fight's going to get stopped. So, yeah, he's got to be smart, but he's also got to pick something at his opponent, chop something at his opponent to keep him off a little bit, too.
There's the combo downstairs. See him trying to cut down that tree with a well-placed right hand. Well off the mark by Dollar Bill. Very accurate work with the hook there after fine, fine defense. Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Jared. Dollar Bill is giving his opponent headaches here now. He's throwing punches, but he's able to block them away.
Stay focused on the inside.
Halfway through this round. Good-looking two-punch combo by Dollar Bill. Good right hand. Wow, what an uppercut. Oh, what a power punch by Big Train.
Keep your back on stroke, baby.
Very nice work to the head. Right hand landed. So he decides to go downstairs early on, and I think he'll be happy with the decision later on.
Well, it tells you that he's a well-prepared fighter. Warner came in here with a good game plan. They understood what they had to do.
Oh, and there they go. He survived earlier, but now he goes down for a second time.
Let's see how I share this film about T-Time, man. Let's see how I share this
just thinking he beat the count and everything's fine.
And I'm not so sure that he can grab. But what you gotta do now, if you're a trainer, the way you taught him in the gym, you don't wanna go grab because you might leave yourself open. Move your head when he comes to you, then you grab him.
And that's the end of round two.
Your best defense
Big
is to throw
Train's
more punches.
Grasp you need to real throw more punches. Is something special. Look how he just stays on the outside
early on in this
fight.
You gotta give him a double jab. You're not giving him a double jab.
And he's able to find his target.
Well, you're right, Joe. It's prime real estate for him. I mean, he's in the neighborhood he wants to be on the outside.
Get at him!
Super two-punch combo by Big Train. Effective work with that flush overhand right. Big Train picking up right where he left off. Remember how he finished that last round?
Yeah, he really finished strong, really fast. And you know what?
He falls victim to that big, big, big shot. Comes crashing home. Well, he's been there before, and now he's there again. He got more.
You can't afford
that head tight. Now he's more convincing. He won.
Is how he reacts in the moments of this fight.
choice of a punt.
And that's the end of round three.
Look at him. He's tied. He's real tied. He's got nothing left.
Beginning of round number four. Teddy, the way your scorecard reads, he's up three rounds to zip. Good, accurate punching earning him that lead.
Yeah, very conservative. Hasn't wasted anything. But as you just touched on, he's made everything count.
Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Dollar Bill showing that he's got some defense of his own. He got away from that punt. Big Train got a great sense of when and how to throw the uppercut. How do you coach a guy up on the uppercut? What do you tell him?
Well, first of all, you don't want it to become a dangerous punt for you. You don't want to drop your hands exposed. You want to make sure that you drop that shoulder a little bit and you don't give up defense for offense.
He gets hit, but he gets it right back. Good job on the two-punch combo by Dollar Bill. He's showing what a skilled fighter he is with the counterpunch.
Well, the old times used to say, if you come here with you, you're going to make it big.
One. Look at him tight in situations right there. A sharp hook to the head by Garrett. Well, targeted two-punch combo by Big Train. Close the show and finish with style. He ends up a knockout victor tonight.
And that's what his trainer wanted. His trainer was even telling him, step it up a little bit because he knew this was possible and they got it.
I'm Joe Tessitore for Teddy Atlas saying thanks for being with us and enjoy the rest of your night.
So, we finna fight next.
Been chopping trees. I done something new for this fight. I done wrestled with an alligator. That's right. I have wrestled with an alligator. I done tussled with a whale. I done handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in jail. That's bad. Only last week, I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick.
Bad dude.
Bad. Fast. Last night I cut the light off in my bedroom, hit the switch, was in the bed before the room was dark. Incredible. Fast. Incredible. You, George Foreman, all of you chumps are going to bow when I whoop him. All of you. I know you got him. I know you got him, Dick. But the man's in trouble. I'm going to show you how great I am.
City Arena here in Midtown Manhattan. Our main event should be a good one tonight. 10 rounds of heavyweight action. This should be a really good matchup here tonight. All that energy that we saw, it almost boiled over at the weigh-in yesterday. Now it gets to explode here in the ring. Big Train's unpredictability belies his ring walk focus. He is ready for action. Babyface Assassin, so attentive when it comes to this moment here. This is where everything he's done, all the hard work he's put in, comes down to one singular moment of concentration.
Remember, guys, obey my commands at all times. Let's have a good, clean fight. Touch him up. Come on, I want to see some
opening round, scheduled for 10. He returns the favor with a right hand of his own. Unable to land clean by Big Train. Big Train's combination punching is working well here. Step back counterpunch where you realize this is the sweet science, not just some raw savagery swinging out there.
Look at the little subtleties here, Joe. What he does is he forces him into a position.
Yeah, you see that? Hey, that's what I was talking about right there. That's what I was talking about.
Big Train's jab can do so much there. He used it well that time. The tactical game paying off. You can see the
counterpunch.
But you know what I see? I see a little tentativeness now in him, because he's afraid to let anything go, because when he misses, bang, he gets caught.
Really good strike here, landing two punches in sequence. Nice block that time. It was intended for the head. Each man able to land an uppercut. That is exactly what the corner wanted to see. A good combination punch by Big Train. Downstairs with a right hand. Took a shot, now he gives a left. But really digs in when he decides to throw that uppercut. Good job. Oh, that's good stuff. Fire it right back with one of his own. Good work by Big Train. He saw the uppercut, he took advantage, throwing it out there. Babyface Assassin is able to land a good, solid left hand.
Bang the box, bang the box.
display of accuracy, and the punch numbers tell
round
that story.
Exactly like that. This is your fight, all right? You're in complete control of this fight. You have to keep moving towards him, all right? Listen, you need to move your head more, side to side, okay? I want to see that head move more. Don't look for just big punches, okay? Use your speed. Double up your punches. I want to see combos.
I got to see him go through a tussle.
Here we go. Round two is underway. That's a razor sharp uppercut by Big Train. And a good counter by Babyface Assassin. The Babyface Assassin committed to that counter punching very early on here in this fight. And that can pay off as the night continues.
Well, it's paying off right now because you see that his opponent now is getting a little worried about letting his hands go. Because every time he doesn't find anything, he finds something coming back.
That's where you want to see.
And there's the left hand working well for him again. Take one, but gets one. Good work by Big Train. And you see what he can do when he gets it. Oh, a big shot coming up. Wow, crushing blow on the
day. But it's gonna be
the kind of boxer find a target.
100%. It might make that might be the pressure. The pressure right might get him before the fight.
And right from the start, he's throwing the power punches and landing them.
I think he has his feet. He wants to get to it.
Basic but beautiful. Jab, left hand.
Yeah, because he would win. He would win, man. Shout out to everybody tuning in over there on TikTok. Man, 30 people on TikTok watching right now. He's going, the numbers going up.
The guy who was just on the floor, what are you telling him?
You're telling him that if he's been down before.
Yeah, but you notice he wasn't doing it after the fight, though.
Sounds crazy, but you say, hey,
I was watching. I'm like, why he ain't doing it as much after the fight as he was doing during the fight? Man, shout out all 50 of y'all tuning, all 60 of y'all tuning in. Oh damn, all 70 of y'all tuning in on TikTok. Appreciate the love. Man, my TikTok going crazy, bro. Man, what up? Oh, we getting to the 80s. Okay, T-Bone defending him. Yeah, hey, pull up. T-Bone defending his, man, I'm about to reach 100, man. Yeah, I'm about to reach 100. It's 90-something people watching. Man, appreciate everybody tuning in on TikTok, man. I'm here defending my title. I'm defending my title. I push poker. Oh, I play poker too. Oh, we done broke the 100 mark, y'all. Appreciate everybody tuning in. I play that joint too, man. I be on. I just won a platinum tournament on poker, bro. Appreciate them follows too. Y'all make sure y'all, everybody tune in. Make sure y'all share the stream, bro. Share the stream, y'all. This man, right, he tried to beat me up. I got my belt on the line, so you know I can't help him. No look in his
head. Good job,
everybody tuning in. What y'all think about the Devin Haney Ryan Garcia fight? It's on crazy. T-Bone comeback guy. Yeah. All right, it's down to 70 now. Still appreciate the people that's still in that chat. We live. Man, I just got up to 130 people now. I'm back to four.
Throw punches, okay? Don't walk into them without throwing a punch. Listen,
who, me?
You need to mix your punches up. Throw more punches to the body.
You can't use, what did it say? Oh, look, why every time I get on the judge, somebody say, oh, look, what do that mean, bro? Somebody say that every time I get on this judge.
Start of round number four, and Teddy's
well, be saying it like, on some,
his opponent's gone
drink
down
sometimes.
So he can just build upon that lead at this point.
Of course, the opponent's acting like a guy who hasn't eaten for weeks, and he's being fed right ahead.
She can take his opponent's aggression and turn it against him.
That's
yeah,
crazy.
Way. I mean,
you don't need Beyonce, yeah.
Coming at you, no better way than to change his mind. Make a miss, make a pay.
Very two-punch combo by the baby face. Keep working
the jab. Good.
Scary movies bore me sometimes.
Halfway through round number four. Committing to the body work now. He lands the right hand. Babyface Assassin coming through now beautifully. That's the combination punch he wants to put forth.
I guess the time of the day made that many people come through.
With the right hand.
Morning,
so
everybody just waking up. I mean, like, so good morning.
Babyface Assassin impressing the judges and himself with that right hand. And now he's targeting upstairs.
You knew someone right.
Throw that jab. Listen to me. You get caught up. You get caught up, and you're fighting his fight. Focus on
time
it.
Out. Yo, what up? I see y'all pulling up to the stream.
Deep breath.
My y'all, I appreciate y'all getting the numbers back up, man. We had 100 and some up in here watching this fight night thing while I'm defending. Appreciate that follow, that I see. It's a blessing. Feel me?
They are back to action here, but that action has only favored one man. Completely one-sided. Hard to see the scorecards coming into play here with how dominating he's been.
I know a lot of y'all remember this fight night.
I think a lot of people probably didn't expect this out of him, but I like the way he looks on the outside.
He's an inside man, but guess what? He's got an outside target.
I find these durable bones.
Jump on good accuracy with that uppercut. What a smart combination by the babyface assassin. Big Train's fighting real smart here on the outside.
Do that again. That looked good. Do that
connects on that exchange. Right to the body. Really on the mark with that over the top shot with the right hand.
Bedroom, hit the switch, was in the bed before the room was gone. Fast. You, George Foreman, all of you chumps are gonna bow when I whoop him. All of you, I know you got him. I know you got him, Dick. But the man's in trouble. I'm gonna show you how great I am.
The old school Friday night champion in the game, y'all. If anybody remember this, y'all. Then look, I put these on the end of the UFC 5. You hear me?
Still keep doing the things you were doing to get you to this place.
Make him pay for his misses. Don't look for just big punches, okay? Use your speed. Double up.
Because he been going up and down.
Of this main event. Left hand came after the jab. Good way to protect the midsection. Return to sender. He gives him back one of his own. Big train's coming up. Big uppercut right on the mark.
Can you read it out? He doing what it takes to make these fight go crazy. I appreciate all 80 of y'all tuning in, man. Y'all going crazy on the TikTok. They going big crazy.
That's the problem, though, when you put those earbuds on, you don't move your head. Some of them are
going to
get through.
They love
your handcuff yourself, so your opponent is going to stay in there a little bit longer, knowing that nothing's coming back right away.
Man, this guy right here, he just don't want to go. Do him like Garcia did Haney. Oh, man. Damn, bro. Hey, that fight right there was crazy, bro. Yeah, I gotta believe it. This damn Haney Garcia fight.
Because
you know, you accept the money.
I done something new for this fight. I done wrestled with an alligator. That's right. I have wrestled with an alligator. I done tussled with a whale. I done handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in jail. That's bad. Only last week, I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick.
Bad dude.
Fast. Fast. Last night, I cut the light off in my bedroom, hit the switch, was in the bed before the room was gone. Fast. You, George Foreman, all of you chumps are gonna bow when I whoop him. All of you, I know you got him. I know you got him, Dick. But the man's in trouble. I'm gonna show you how great I am.
We defend in the UFC.
want to know, can a guy punch? Can a guy defend? You know, can a guy control distance? But you want to know, can a guy finish? He got the answer. Yes, he can finish.
For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore.
We still got our belt. We still looking good. Let's put it back on the line again. I see y'all pulling up to the stream. I appreciate the love, appreciate the blessings. It's more than a blessing for me to entertain y'all with this going ham I be doing on this. Man, I see y'all. Danny John, what up, man? See that USA title, right? Oh. Got on the line. Oh my goodness. Ray, I see you. Appreciate you being number one viewer. No. Please, it's number 5 for the week. I'm looking monthly. For the month. Yeah. I just see he even on there right now. Title defense, y'all see the USA belt right there. I'm finna defend it, man. You hear me? Man, y'all make sure everybody tune in, do me a favor, and share the stream. Appreciate the follow, Maddox.
Good evening, everybody. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and welcome to the MGM Grand. Here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, for a much anticipated main event.
I see y'all pulling up some
rounds strength in the heavyweight division, and the anticipation for this bout has grown as the week has gone on. A lot of talk behind these two. Now it's time to walk the walk. Big Trent making his way to the ring now, and you can see how focused he is on the task.
I don't think this is the case.
Edwards is coming down to the ring right now. Not seeing much personality out of this ring walk.
Yo, appreciate everybody tuning in again. Matthew Bell on the line. Okay, yeah, we see his record. We see his record. My everybody, make sure y'all follow and make sure y'all share the stream. Miles 78 of y'all. Appreciate y'all tuning in. Make sure y'all share the stream. I'm here to entertain.
All the talk, all the hype, now the fight. Round one scheduled for 10. Nice block by Edwards. That's a nice combination. Left hook to the body, right hand.
Nice block. Yeah.
Very well done by both men to fire off those right hands.
Shots off on me.
And now he's targeting upstairs.
But we in here for a fight. We put our title on the line. But everybody on fire. Everybody on fire from the alley. They ain't from the USA. That's why. But my belt still on the line. I mean, it still counts as a title. It still counts as a title. But I don't know who he is. Yeah, man, it's still the title.
You see that? Boom, boom, gone down.
Yeah, it's still the title before. Unless
boy,
the fight, you know, the fights that don't be counting when it's over. That ain't gonna count as no title before. Trying it, appreciate it. But my number's jumping from 2080 to 20. Appreciate each and every individual tuned in right now, y'all. All the blessings. Let's put this belt back on the line again that we got right there. The USA title. Let's do it. Pop up, let's see. Nope, it's not good. We still gonna fight though. We still gonna do it though.
Good evening, everybody. Glad you've made the decision to be with us. Alongside Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore, and we're glad to be bringing you action and welcoming you to the Mexico City Plaza. Here in Mexico City for a much anticipated main event. 10 rounds of heavyweights. Boy, and we expect this to be a big night of action. We spoke with both fighters yesterday. Fireworks anticipated here tonight. Let's see.
This boy 6-0, everybody tuned in. We got somebody that ain't comfortable with losing. He ain't here to do what he do. He ain't here to show the people that I ain't finna be the one to stop him from continuing, but I say otherwise. Appreciate everybody pulling up to the stream.
Opening 3 minutes of this 10-round fight. What an excellent two-punch combo by Big Train. A little head-hunted in with the left. Is on the bad end of a big hook upstairs. He has found his groove with this right.
appreciate that, Frisky. Frisky too, too big. I see you with the follow. Bless you. I'm saying something in the... Okay, he thinks he's doing something. Hold up, dude. Hold up.
Big Train's probably sitting back.
What's up, my boy?
Some serious damage to his opponent.
Yeah, you know what really did it was that left hook to the liver, that body shot.
Totally,
you know, that's like going into a restaurant, you get a stain on your jacket, you know, and the stain just doesn't come out. You know, you go to your cleaners, it's still there. Those body shots, they don't come out. They stay with you round after round, and they keep more damage. They keep paying off for you. You got the benefit of that body work on.
Get rid of that body shot.
Oh, Chisnut, I see you. I see.
Is doing well here with that two punch combination. Side. Keeps his hands up defensively, protecting the head. He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. Good scoring shot. It was a straight right. He brings an uppercut that really does damage there. A good clean old 1-2 by Big Train. Big Train's way off the mark. That punch didn't have a chance. Work the left hand to the head. Look at this, another power punch able to land. Swirly out in this fight, he's going for it.
Yeah, you wonder if he's got a call waiting outside.
Good 1-2 by Big Train.
There you go, man. Appreciate you, Tyria 99 for the foul.
Scores well to the head with the right hand. Bad intentions is so dangerous with that accuracy. A two-punch combination landing. Some serious damage done on that power shot to the head.
Drops his hand, paid a price.
Big Green putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination.
Keep back up the rope.
Worked out well with the uppercut. A well-targeted jab that time.
And that's exactly what you need when you want to stay on the outside. Something to keep you away from your opponent.
Lands flush with the two-punch combo by Big Train. Just 10 seconds to go here in the second round.
You hear me? You touch me. Look.
Big Train's proving that he's here to fight.
Let's look at the punch jab. Yeah, I see everybody pulling up. I see y'all pulling up to a honey deep.
Beautiful job. Nice work.
I see y'all a honey deep in here, man.
Moving in with his head
up in here stepping, bro. I'm trying to make sure that we do what we do every time somebody get in the ring, man. It's early in the morning. Oh, y'all y'all trying to work up to 200 viewers. That's what I'm talking about, man, because I'm here. What up? Just you need to tune in to TikTok right now. For real. I got almost 200 people watching me right now. Hey, everybody tune in, man. Bitch, I'm out here to show y'all high level of my belt on the line. I'm defending it against whoever this is thinking they can beat me. Hey, everybody tune in, man. Man, make sure y'all hit that follow. Make sure y'all share the stream, bro. Yeah, y'all share the stream. Everybody else get a chance to witness with y'all. Get to see this old school fun. And I'm me, myself, Mr. Train Rick himself.
In chapter 3, I've done something new for this fight. I done wrestled with an alligator. That's right. I have wrestled with an alligator. I done tussled with a whale. Out of handcuffed lightning, those thunders in. That's bad. Only last week, I murdered a rock. Angel of stone. I fertilized a brick. I'm so mean on their horses. Bad dude. Fast. Man, I cut the light off my bed. Get the bed before the room is dark. Fast. You, George Fulmer, all of you chumps are going to bow when I whoop him. All of you. I know you got him. I know you got him, Dick. But the man's in trouble. I'm going to show you how great I am.
This is a fight. I was good to see. Fight night. See, most people that play fight night playing with Mike Tyson. Ooh, got him. Stop playing with me.
Been chopping trees. I've done something new for this fight. I've wrestled with an alligator. That's right. I have wrestled with an alligator. I've tussled with a whale. I've handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in there. That's fast. Only last week, I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick. Fast. You, George Fulmer, all of you chumps are gonna bow when I whoop him. All of you, I know you got him. I know you got him, Dick. But the man's in trouble. I'm gonna show you how great I am.
You need to cover up, okay? You're leaving yourself open too much. Cover up. You need to throw.
Big trains in complete.
Opponent keeps squaring up with him, giving him a lot of surface, and he's finding that surface.
Bad intentions is nailed. And now you can see him doing some fine work here on the outside of his opponent.
You know, and I agree.
You
already know he's going to win on the inside. That's his
somebody owe that to go.
Now he's controlling things outside. It's not.
Hey, everybody tune in. Tell me what y'all think about the Devin Haney and Ryan Garcia fight, man. And I'm talking about on all platforms, y'all. What y'all think about it? Thank you.
throw him off with some head.
Score
that's
that round when
throw him
man
off with
was able to hurt the other.
Well, this is where you have to
you
be
have
a good
start
judge.
Start throwing in volume in there.
You
throw in volume.
The information that's there. Who won the spots of the round before they each hurt each other? And who hurt the other guy a little more?
What did I tell you? Keep your hands up, right? Yeah. Now you're throwing your punches, put your hands in there. You good? Okay, now focus.
As we start a new round, Teddy, this seems basically hopeless for him. He's been knocked down numerous times tonight.
Well, you never know. I mean, you go back to the 1980 Olympics.
Step
back, counter punch.
Beautiful.
Big range combination punching is just perfect there. Three punches landing.
He is fine.
Missed by a mile. That wasn't even close by Big Train. Good shot to the head with that right hand.
That's where you want to be. Good job, baby.
Targeted counter punch by Bad Intention. Big Train's got a real acquired skill here, and that is the ability to pick your shots and land.
So you hear the saying when people say, you know what time it is. You have to know what time it is. He knows what time it is. He knows when to slow a certain punch.
Just still not moving enough.
Very nice work from both men. He's got a shot in. As if the right hand wasn't enough. How about that accurate left hook? He just landed to the midsection. There's a straight right hand. Buries the punch. Comes back with the hook. That wants to do just that. Find the target, get the combination working, land both punches. Little head knocking with
move
that right
it,
hand.
Move it.
Not able to connect with the uppercut. A big right hand. He doesn't look good, but then he's throwing rather than clinching.
He's more than one
piercing left hand by Big Train. Bad Intentions is now doing what he should have probably been doing a little early on. I like what we saw out of him in that last round. Now, we still have a losing this fight, but he's closed the gap.
Yeah, he's picking it up, you know, and that's exactly what he has to do is pick it up a little bit. You know, if he was in a car race, he was going about 40 miles an hour, everybody else going 50. Now he's got it up to 45, 48.
Listen, I need
a couple
to
more
see
miles
some power,
you know,
punches,
push
okay
that gas pedal a little
whatever
more, Joe,
misses,
and he might be
know
there.
What's going on, man.
You're doing fine. He's just beating you to the punch, that's all. You need to throw more. If you're not punching.
The start of the sixth round.
Oh.
Oh, and a big right hand lands. Bad Intentions is in a much better place now. This is a good comeback. I wonder if he can come all the way back in this fight.
Why not?
Excellent 1-2 by Big Train.
Why are you crying?
See how he just set the table for that right hand after the jab.
Okay, say it.
Nice work with the overhand right.
Oh, I got you, man. Show me what you're doing.
Oh, he just misses with that headshot. Big Train going that walking stick right now, utilizing the jab. Big Train. Well timed, well placed uppercut there.
aren't there?
Yeah, counterpunch opportunities, because he got an opponent who's walking in a little bit. Now he has a chance to start to chuck something back at him.
A clean, crisp right hand by Big Train. Big Train's putting punches together now. That's a nice combination. Now targeting his opponent with the overhand right. Bad intentions is probably trying to assess things right now.
Keep your hands up. And
I think it's a close, good, solid fight that he's fought very much in. But I do think he's on the downside of the scorecards.
Yeah, but the most important thing is he has to know that. See, that's the thing. Can a fighter be honest with himself? And that's where the corner comes in. Somebody has to whisper in his ear and say, hey, listen, you might think you're in this place, but the reality,
come forward this
you're
round.
Not.
Keep that jab moving. Keep him away again. From it, all right? I you need you to keep moving. Like
back to action here at the start of this round. That last round was very interesting because it was the kind of round that can turn a fight in a completely new direction. He did well.
Yeah, you know, the old time saying was, good start, good finish. Well, that's what he's hoping for. Good finish.
Oh, a good right hand by Big Train. Big Train showing you that sublime skill right now with that two-punch combo. See, he's got his guard up really well that time as he protects his head.
Yeah, I like
that. Take one, get one. The right hand scores well. Right to the belt line. There's the old 1-2 coming after him. Watch the headshot. Big Train doing well here with that two-punch combination. Able to lock in that target and bring it home well.
One or two more of those. It'll be the end of the night.
How is he able to do this? How is he able to take these shots?
You know, one time Muhammad Ali talked about taking a chin. He had one of the great chins of all time. And what he basically talked about was that when you start to get those shots, you start to go down a hallway. And then you go into a gray room. You go from a light room to a gray room. And at the end of the hallway, you see a dark room. You don't want to go to that dark room. And you have a choice. You put your feet down, you start backing up. I'm not going to that dark room. This guy is not being taken to that dark room.
And round seven comes to an end. As we start round number eight, I want to take a look at Teddy's scorecard, and I also want to ask you of an underlying storyline that's developed here. Because, yes, you have him up, but that's because he has scored knockdowns. This is a very close fight, and his opponent is hanging in there. Could he be discouraged because of that?
Obviously, that can always happen, but part of being a professional fighter, and if you want to become a champion, is you do not allow yourself to go into those mental corridors.
Oh, good exchange there. Crashes home with a hook. Good return fire that time. Left hook, right hand, well done, especially to the body. Blocks that punch. Bad intentions is nailed by a hook. Big Train's really bringing a lot with that uppercut, Teddy. How much of a factor is the lower body in bringing the power behind that punch?
Well, that's a good question. That's everything. You ever watch Tiger Woods when he's hitting a golf ball? You know, he just drives his lower body through that ball. What's the same thing? Your lower body, your hips, you rotate them, and you just drive that lower body up into your punch.
Well, something's got to stick. He sends the combination to the body. To the head he goes with a left hand.
but I want you to keep those hands moving.
Hi, everybody. So glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to the Aragon Ballroom here in Chicago, Illinois, for tonight's main event. 10 rounds among heavyweights. Each man comes into this fight supremely confident, expecting to deliver a W.
Remember, guys, obey my commands at all times. Let's have a good, clean fight.
Man.
Touch him up.
You got your little get to know you here in the opening round scheduled for 10.
You're on the side of, you're on the side of the USA title.
That counterpunch was very effective. He scored well. Nice work by Boom Boom.
Halfway through this round.
enough to be out of danger, but still close enough to then land a counterpunch.
Well, that's what happens when you have that kind of experience. You're calm enough to know that range. Know where the beginning of the punch and the end of the punch is.
They both decide to bring it. Boom Boom's doing what every trainer wants to see their fighter do. Land punches in punches, the combination lands. Staying away from those head shots with his defense up top. Final 10 seconds of round number one. And a stark counterpunch by Boom Boom. Boom Boom's corner's got to be thrilled with what they just saw. They won that last round. They put down a beatdown on their opponent. And now they got to be thinking, hey, this thing can really snowball in our favor big time.
Yeah, they have to feel that way. Keep it going. Why change it? You know,
solid shot. The left hand came in. He gives as well as he takes. You saw it on that exchange. Big Train's so dangerous with that accuracy. A two-punch combination land.
Harvey.
There's the uppercut. One of my favorite punches that works that time for him.
Right. 200 people on TikTok watching me.
So he goes down, but able to get up to his feet. Teddy, what should he be thinking about now?
Well, right now, just surviving. But if he survives, then he better figure out why he was put on the floor.
Not able to land the headshot. Defense easily turns into offense. Blocks a blow, sends an uppercut. Big Train's on the bat end of a very impressive hook up top. See how he targets that hook? Have to do their job after both men went out and gave everything they had. Both fighters get tagged and hurt by the other.
Yeah, well, what you have to do now is corner, so with your little time, you have to revitalize the fighter. Put some cold water on his head, on his neck, you know, get him ready for the next shot and give him some good advice. Tell him how to wait, get away from some of those shots.
Off the target by Big Train. Come on. Big Train's trying to get back in this round after being knocked down in the last round. Only just 60 seconds between rounds. How much can really happen? How much can really benefit a fighter who was knocked down?
Well, a lot has to happen. First of all, you hit him with that sponge. Some cold water on top of the head where you revigorate him a little bit. You know, get his senses back a little bit. And you have to talk to him. Once he calms down, once you physically get him back on track, you look to see if he's okay, and then you have to tell him why he got dropped to begin with.
Final right hand by Boom Boom. Reaching the halfway mark of this round. Resourceful hook by Big Train. Up top with the right hand. Boom Boom's putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination.
Forward.
And now he brings the left hand upstairs.
You're not focusing.
Mm-hmm.
not going to stand here and watch you take those shots. You understand me?
Mm-hmm.
Let's see more defense and more.
You're in control of this fight, but don't get careless out there. Keep boxing smart. Okay, listen. Don't let him.
Boom Boom's enjoying a big lead here. Up 3-0 on Teddy's scorecard. More important than that, he's already gotten to his man.
Yeah, he's hurt him in the body, and once he hurt him in the body, he throws upstairs, was able to go there.
Well played, straight right hand. Teddy, what would you recommend based on what we're seeing here tonight?
Well, two aspirin and then actually, I would say a little counterpunching would be just what the doctor wants.
That's a better prescription for him. How about that? Another right hand. Oh, what a win by Boom Boom. Oh, that's good stuff. Fired right back with one of his own. Good work by Big Train. Boom Boom's landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by Big Train.
Come on, kid, focus.
Now a well-placed hook to the head. Big Train's combination punching working out well there. He landed three solid shots. Boom Boom staying away from trouble. He's out there on the outside.
Focus.
Jaja, I appreciate that follow.
Boom, boom.
Beautiful, lindísimo, beautiful. I want another round
was
like
a big
that.
Improvement. I mean, this that's more of what he's trying to accomplish in this fight. Down on the scorecards, but now things headed in a better direction.
To me, he's cooperating with his opponent before. Right now, he's arguing with him. Hey, arguing is good in boxing.
Oh, nice two-punch combo by Big Train.
Because he's waiting for things to happen that are not happening. You know, he's laying back, he's waiting for the guy to walk in. See, to be a good counterpuncher, an effective counterpuncher, the guy has to come close to him. But his opponent's staying at a distance. He's not giving him anything to counter.
Oh, he's got something for himself, and it's a left hand. A little head hunting with the right. Boom's got a cut. It looks like it's below the eye, on the cheek, but it's something that needs to be blocked. Clutch right hand to the head. Super two-punch combo by Boom Boom.
I love you going ham.
Still there. You can't catch the head. Go downstairs to the body. You paralyze that head. You start to take that movement away. Before you know it, the guy's not quite as elusive.
Yeah, fair.
Nice strike after catching one by downstairs. She puts forth a right hand.
Man, you were gonna be feeling bad, right?
Punch is far off the target. He lands the uppercut on the back end of a left hook upstairs.
You did, right? I be doing it.
Snapping hook and it does damage.
Sometimes I go after you, I'm like, you know what? I ain't gonna do it, cool.
Halfway through round six. Accuracy an issue there. Didn't land that straight right hand.
But it'd be too late, though.
And now he's targeting upstairs. Oh, he took some damage, but he gave some back with the right hand.
Yep, because you know you ain't trying to go down a certain road.
And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Big Train's really in a groove right now.
I don't know, you know you're in. Hold up, Bob, man, he got something to go.
Boom, boom, doing a good job tonight on the outside. He's able to score from the outside, keeping a safe distance away from his opponent.
Yeah, yeah. Yo, EBB. Okay, bitch, stand on that. He said, and I'm lane switching. That boy that say money ain't everything. I said, that nigga that tripping. Nigga, my hood full of dope cooker. Blue face Cardi full of no booty. Gucci down, head to toe, with just a match.
I need another round, but when your eyes shuts closed like that, everything changes.
But one thing doesn't change, though, and that's the mentality of a warrior.
I was, as soon as I heard this shit, I started bumping this shit.
You find a way, you concentrate harder, and you stick with that one eye.
Nah, hell nah, him, nah, Yak sound way more fluid. Yeah, he don't sound fluid like Yak, nah, he said, I was shocked when he said he was from Florida.
Well, right there's a good example of the benefit of combination punching. You missed the first, second, third,
I was shocked when he said he was from Florida. I was like, oh, this nigga from
Florida. Now he goes down again.
Yeah, for sure that is just not his sound.
He gets up after that punch, put him down on the canvas.
Now he needs to get on that bicycle and stay away from this guy.
Big Train.
I hate that, man. And they taught us out. They taught us out with this shit, man. This is
start of round number eight here. One guy up big, but Big Train's got that ability, Teddy. He has it, and he put him down earlier. He could do it again.
And he just has to be reminded of that. And that's where Quarterman comes in. You know, you think about Quarterman coming in, but he's got to get water, he's got to revive. practice at it, so he might figure it out.
Trying to fight me. Take care of your being, cause I'm trying to fight the random defend my build anyway. Get T-bone 1 second, everybody. Man. You need me. Thank you. You gonna run the whole Moses? I need to proceed. We can do something else, but man, you might go to school. The only reason I want to get that prestige and out the way, so I ain't got to keep doing it no more. Once it's done, it's over. After this game, after the next game I play, I'm going to be at 9. Now, 9 will get you the golden score. 10 will give you an extra rope. Mm-hmm. Now, you see how Killer Emblem look around his name, and how T-Chick look around his name. When they... Yeah, I got that red M around mine. They got the silver and the gold. Get the score around there, yo. Yeah, me too. Like they doing fight night. I was thinking about playing the scene too. Mm-hmm. I remember them. Cause we were going going in on this. We are about them shit. Did we pay for it? We paid for it. Did we buy it? I'm looking up about it. I think I did though. I think I went on pavement more. Damn, I'm paying 16. Tell about 16%. I don't think it's 16%. I might be true. Hell no. I've been streaming the same shit. On his stuff, yeah, he won 20 million. Thank you. $12 million on top of his purse. Fight company. It's a good work. I ain't even been in this one that long, and I'm already building myself up to buy another house. Me too, man. I'm bored too. I ain't gonna leave it down, bro. To really tackle fights, you can't tackle how old fights is. You throw a couple blows, you gonna lose that motherfucker. And your man, you gonna be like, as long as I know I can beat him in my mind, fuck it. You're going to take them out. Only thing got me has somewhat playing this shit because I got the belt. Let me see how many motherfuckers I got. I don't know, I got a couple more to go. At least two or three, two more to be. Maybe even three. We still got everything for sure, for sure. Man, it might be fresh for the stream. Let me see. How so we got who? I just put everyone in the bathroom.
the corporate AI filed for bankruptcy. One subcycle left for my account.
Gentlemen, magnificita, the FM, mini rocker flitter,
Spitzwal, von Speck firms,
Tipau, Moya, good handy frontiers, da Panfig or did,
Vigrefe, Kimin firms, Swal, Mini Kivagri, Nijio, Pira, Moka, Grass, Bidul, Mer.
Now, what we, now, how we, what's this shit we were doing to see where we go? Yeah, okay, y'all. Up on the and what we missing, how we check all our shit select. What you say? You see in the background what's up tactical you are too. Okay, so let me see. Not private.
Da hema auf Bekeve Alpha Tup.
Attention, arcology now in default mode.
Right.
When we need a company rally or inspirational cap mugs to hand out, I'll let you know, okay?
Why the hostility, Poon? All I'm saying is that we should stick together in a time of crisis, and that we're here to help in any way we can.
And all I'm saying is that I don't see how you can... Cinder idiots.
Oh, look, Mike. The Ascent Group AGI. Now, all we got is
my painting a bleak enough picture.
The ladies' cream of the. With everything going on, they're seeing an opportunity to strengthen their stock.
All right, enough questions.
Oh,
feel fear.
Questions? Shoot. I expect they're busy ejecting them firstly, but I guess that's what you can expect. They're threatening to attack the ladies with everything going on. They're threatening to attack the ladies cream with everything going on. They're seeing an opportunity to.
Is that all?
You must be Poon's late. Looks like you here. It's a blip off you gone.
Where's the party?
Don't worry. I'm on.
Further from your wet wearing deeds.
Mission complete. This is again and shit again. Oh, I'm stuck right here. Oh my god. Nah. I'm just standing right here. You see my gas stick right here? see me? Nah, I can't even. Yeah, this would have, this shit was happening to me when I was talking to the fire. I had to stop talking to him because this shit kept happening. I played it one time, like about a month ago. Hold on, let me check. Okay, all my shit right here was fine. Thank you. Thank you.
We'll be right back. Damn, follow
stuck to me. I couldn't get out. Why can't you use the other things I get? Oh shit, I didn't even know I was getting hit, man. I'm gonna be having some dick spray. This That's it. my new side whip was out my range and my spider did hop in my Mitchell sauce. Instant. Let me know when you need to. See, I'm playing my machine gun is an MK23. Not MK4, I mean. Yeah. But now my BC7 is an MK9. My BC7, my energy weapon is a MK9. My energy cannon, an MK9, Now my dread an MK7, but it's weak though. I think it ain't got that many. Cause see, I'm using this MK4 weapon, cause it got them 100 rounds, I think. Yeah, that's why. And my dread, even though it's an MK8, that motherfucker only got 40 rounds. Yeah, see, and then I'm comparing all these other weapons. Fix my shit back. Yeah.
Thank you. Well, well. Krug told me you might come loaded. And here you are. Very nice. I'll let Krug know you delivered. Well, well. Krug told me you might come loaded. And here you are. Very nice. I'll let Krug know you delivered.
Thank you.